being here, we're going to open up with one of our favorite songs. Anybody know what our favorite song is at?
Soul on Fire.
What's it called?
Soul on Fire.
All right, now let's do Soul on Fire. Here we go. Entangle me with some things that I should not be entangled with. And when I entangle myself with these things, the light that's in the fire that we should have How many believe we should have some fire?
Amen.
Yes.
The fire that I should have is burned out. And it gets low. And I begin to close my mouth and I begin to lose my countenance. I'm not the light that God wants me to be. I'm here to lead us back to the cross. Return to the cross. Return to Christ. Return to those foundations which you and I have in Jesus Christ. It's a foundation of faith. It's a foundation of love. It's a foundation of forgiveness. Amen?
Amen.
It's the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ. And you and I, we don't have to be quiet about our faith. Amen? The fact is, we're imperfect people. Amen? But don't let being imperfect take away the power of your mouth and the power of your heart to just bear forth the light of Christ to a lost and dying world. We all need Jesus. That's the bottom line. Amen? So Jesus said this. He said, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it will remain alone. But if it dies, everybody say, if it dies, it will bear forth much fruit. So I believe each and every day, Jesus said this, if you want to follow me, if you want to be mine, you have a responsibility to take up your cross, deny yourself, die to yourself, and then come and follow after me.
Yes.
Jesus himself, he said this, I have a baptism to undergo. How many know what that baptism was? It was a baptism of death each and every day. Every step was leading him to his destiny to give his life away. Amen. And so we have a baptism, church, to undergo. And I know as we submit to that baptism, as we allow God to purge us of all defilement of flesh and spirit, he's perfecting holiness in the fear. He's perfecting you. And we have to, most importantly, we have to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus.
Amen.
Keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. But I just know that God is sweetly breaking you and I. Everybody say, God is sweetly breaking. He's sweetly breaking me. So that you and I, again, the light might go forth. And I just want to encourage you this morning to worship the Lord like you've never worshipped before. When the fire of God, the Holy Spirit, comes upon you, it's for a purpose. And that purpose is for you and I to undergo his working, his doing in our lives. Amen?
Amen?
And when it gets hot, you can either run from the fire or you can submit to the fire. But when you submit and you're sweetly broken, there comes forth a new life in Christ. That is so fantastic. It is unbelievable the life that God has for you and I if we will follow him and we will submit to him. So this morning, let's just, Lord, I'm being sweetly broken, but I know as I'm being sweetly broken, your life, your power, your authority is going to come forth from me, and I'm going to be a usable vessel for you. That's our worship this morning. Amen. Let's pray. And I just want to encourage you the next half hour just to sit in your seat, raise your hands. Maybe you just want to kneel down. This altar is open. This is not a show. This is a time for you and I to get real with our God. Amen. Lord, we want to get real with you. So we just present ourselves to you right now. We're being sweetly broken. And Lord, we welcome you, Holy Spirit, in this house. And I pray that you would accomplish great things right now as we just fix our eyes on you. And we begin to worship you. We invite you, Lord, to accomplish your work and change us this morning by the power of your Holy Spirit. And all God's people said,
amen.
I'm sorry. surrender. Show us, Lord, how to surrender deeper to your work, to your ways, to your will, God. We're praying not our will, but your will be done in our lives. So holy fire,
oh, burn away my desire. Thank you.
prayer for all of us here this morning is that we would become more aware of your presence. And truly, Lord, as we set our hearts to follow you, despite our imperfections, despite our weakness and failures, despite us, Lord, your glory, the goodness of your glory might be seen in our lives. Even as Moses cried out, he said, Lord, would you pass before me? He hid himself in the cleft of the rock, and he asked, Lord, I want to see you. Lord, if you want me to go forward, I'm going to need you. And so, Lord, would you allow your goodness to pass by? Lord, would you allow your mercies? Lord, can I see your goodness and your mercies? And the goodness and the mercies went before. And I just believe the goodness and mercy is going to follow you and I all the days of our lives. If we'll focus in on Christ, we have nothing to fear, saints. We have nothing to be intimidated by. There's not an enemy that can conquer Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ already conquered the grave. And now his mercy and his forgiveness, it reigns. It reigns in you and I as his believers that love him. Lord, let us continue to see your goodness and your glory. That's your worship, saints, before your God. Some of us are wondering, I've even wondered myself, how can I even go forward and do what God's called me to do? Oh, wretched man that I am, Paul said. And I'm convinced more and more our worship is our ability to receive and believe in Jesus Christ like never before. That's our worship, saints. We can't go back. How many of you can't go back?
That's right.
You can only go forward. Whatever God says to do, you say, God, I submit myself to you, and I'm trusting in you. I'm trusting in your mercies every day. Our Savior King.
Then now the weak say, I have strength.
Say that this morning.
By the Spirit of power that raised Christ from the dead. Then now the
afraid of. Nothing. Whatever it is you're facing, I just want to encourage you, the cross is the answer. Surrender is the answer this morning. No matter what you're going through, I was talking with my brothers this Saturday morning. The bottom line for everything that you and I are going through is an attitude of surrender. We're going to talk about this morning just an attitude of humility. Let me say an attitude of humility. An attitude of brokenness. That's the only thing that's going to save us. Amen. That attitude. James is going to help us worship the Lord in our giving this morning.